Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to China Showtime. There are currently two space stations in outer space. One is the International Space Station, and the other is China's Tiangong Space Station. The International Space Station was built in 1998 as the world's first space station. It is the largest aerospace project in the world, and it is mainly jointly constructed by 16 countries including the United States, Russia, Europe, Japan, and the Canadian Space Agency. At that time, China also applied to join the International Space Station, but was rejected by the United States. However, China has not given up on pursuing the development of the aerospace industry. In order to keep up with the development of space technology in the world, China independently designed and built the Tiangong Space Station, which belongs to China and is open to cooperate with the world. At this time, NASA of the United States applied to China to join the Tiangong Space Station cooperation, but China rejected the request of the United States. So, why does China reject the United States, a developed country? Maybe when you know the truth, you will applaud. Thanks for watching the video. With the development of aerospace technology, the world space competition is becoming more and more obvious. The United States once ranked first in aerospace technology, and now China is also following the pace of the world's aerospace technology and has become an aerospace superpower. Today, China's aerospace technology is getting stronger and stronger, and its strength in aerospace engineering construction indicates that China is likely to catch up with the United States in the future, which makes Western developed countries begin to feel fear. However, once China's aerospace industry develops, it cannot be carried out because it has been obstructed by the United States many times. The development of China's aerospace technology is very difficult. The biggest reason is the restriction by Western countries. For example, in 1956, the rocket developed by China was recognized by aerospace companies of other countries. In Motorola's Iridium project in the United States, China has also successfully won several orders, and both parties expressed a happy cooperation. But the United States did something that surprised China. At that time, the United States actually fabricated a Cox report, claiming that China had stolen important technology from the United States with fabricated evidence. With China confirming that all the contents of the report are false, the United States still uses this charge to ban American satellites from using Chinese-made rockets, and even prohibits the use of all pods from China. In other words, many aerospace science and technology projects in developed countries such as Europe and the United States exclude China. For example, when the International Space Station was under construction in 1993, China's aerospace technology at that time was not enough to build a space station by itself, but it also intended to contribute to the common space technology of mankind. So China applied to join the International Space Station led by the United States. However, the United States actually rejected China's application on the grounds that China's aerospace technology is insufficient. You must know that the aerospace technology of Spain, the Netherlands, Greece, and other countries was far inferior to that of China. But the United States agreed to join these countries in the research of the International Space Station. But China was rejected by the United States. Obviously, the United States' rejection of China is not because of China's lack of space technology, but because the United States wants to block and monopolize China's space technology. More importantly, the U.S. Congress passed the Wolf Clause in 2011, which clearly limits U.S.-China space cooperation. The terms state that federal funds cannot be used for any form of cooperation or coordination with China on its space program, and banning NASA from receiving any official visitors from China. The Wolf Clause announced by the United States has made it difficult for China's aerospace industry to develop. However, China has not given up on the development of the aerospace industry because of this. China is aware of the wariness of Western countries towards China, and they are very worried that China has learned aerospace technology to develop and grow, which will cause Western countries to be dissatisfied with China, lose the edge in space exploration. Since then, China has no longer asked to join the International Space Station, but has invested in its own technical research in the aerospace field. After nearly 10 years of long-term research, Chinese scientific researchers have successfully broken through the technical blockade of Western countries in the aerospace field, and China's aerospace technology has made great progress. The space rockets independently developed and built by China later, the Shenzhou series of rockets and the Tiangong space station are enough to prove China's efforts in developing the space industry. After the successful launch of the Tiangong space station independently developed by China, China is willing to provide opportunities for other countries to use the Tiangong space station. On the other hand, although the International Space Station is called international, in fact, only countries that invest in the construction of the International Space Station or provide technical support are eligible to arrange astronauts to board the International Space Station. However, China's Tiangong Space Station has released positive and friendly signals in promoting cooperation in space exploration. It will also provide opportunities for joint exploration of space by many nations that previously did not have access to space. At present, there are only two space stations above the Earth. One is the International Space Station, and the other is China's Tiangong Space Station. It is understood that the International Space Station has been operating in space for 20 years and has now entered the decommissioning stage. According to the consensus reached by the partners of the International Space Station, the International Space Station is about to be decommissioned. After 2030, there will be only one space station left in space, and that is China's Tiangong Space Station. So far, China has received a total of 42 Tiangong Space Station cooperation projects from 27 countries. And so far, China has received a total of 9 cooperation projects from 17 countries and 23 entities. Among them, the United States also applied to join China's Tiangong Space Station, but China rejected the application of the United States, because China believes that the scientific value and technology proposed by the United States did not meet the standards required by China. China has rejected the application of the United States, but the United States expressed disappointment with China's refusal and also discredited China's space monopoly. But in fact, all countries in the world are very clear about who is using their privileges to implement a space monopoly. More importantly, China does not exclude applications from any country, as long as the Chinese side believes that the scientific value and technical content meet Chinese standards, they can be allowed to join. Therefore, China does not practice the so-called space monopoly at all. U.S. research programs are only rejected in the first batch of applications. China will continue to implement the second and third batches of plans. The United States can continue to submit applications in China's future Tiangong program. Now, China has achieved world-renowned achievements in the development of space technology. And China has also expressed its willingness to cooperate with other countries to explore space and contribute to the common space technology of mankind. I believe that with the development of China's aerospace technology, it will become stronger and stronger in the future, even surpassing the United States.